After the Prime Minister attacked the opposition, stating that their remarks demanding evidence of the Indian Air Force airstrikes were making headlines in Pakistan media, the Congress has hit back. Senior Congress leader Digvijay Singh has once again attacked the Prime Minister. In fact, Digvijay Singh tweeted that he had full faith in the armed forces, but it's the BJP leaders who have been issuing contradictory figures in terms of casualties. Former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram also said that the party was not questioning the forces, but the Prime Minister and the BJP. Meanwhile, Union Minister Rajyavardhan Singh Rathod took the opportunity to attack the Congress, whereas leader of the Congress party, Kapil Sibal, who had quoted international media houses to question terror casualties in the airstrikes. Rathore said, Kapil Sibal, if he believed international media more than intelligence agencies. In fact, he continued his attack and said that if Kapil Sibal could go to the United Kingdom for EVMs, he could also have gone to Balakot to find out the real truth.
अरे मोदी की बात मत मानो भाई, मैं नहीं कहता हूं मेरी बात मानो, कम से कम सेना पर तो अविश्वास मत करो। उनके पराक्रम पर तो दाग मत लगाओ, वो जान की बाजी लगा करके खेलता है, वो देश के लिए मर मिटने के लिए निकलता है और सफल होकर के आता है, तो आपकी नींद खराब हो जा रही है।
Sometimes I don't understand what the Prime Minister wants to say. Not a day passes, and not a day has passed in the last 14 days, when he's not made a political election speech in some part of India. And he has used every speech to bash the Congress party and the leadership of the Congress party. Now that's politicization. And when he says, we are questioning the Indian Army. Who has questioned the Indian Army? Congress President was the first to tweet, I salute the Indian Air Force. We're not questioning the Indian military forces.
Let's also play out now some other political reactions that is coming in on this political slugfest between the BJP and the Congress over the Pulwama airstrikes.
So I say that why are they talking so much? These Congress people are talking about their education qualification. अपना धर्म पर झूठ बोलते हैं, कौन आप उनका मजहब है उस पर झूठ बोलते हैं, हाँ नहीं, ये सारा झूठा जीवन है इन सबका। और फिर मोदी को कहते हैं झूठा है, वो भी झूठा है।
सेना के शौर्य को किसी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के पोस्टर पर मत लगाइए। सेना के बारे में कभी कोई प्रश्न नहीं हुआ, प्रश्न आपके मनसा वाचा कर्मणा पे है, आपकी कार्यशैली पे है, क्योंकि पुलवामा के शहीदों के सुरक्षा चुप पे चुप रहे, सुरक्षा चौक पे, लेकिन पुलवामा के शहीदों की तस्वीर लगा करके आप पॉलिटिकल रैली कर रहे हैं। मेरे मुल्क का चरित्र बड़ा बढ़िया था।
आई एम डिमांडिंग दैट मिस्टर अमित शाह शुड टेल द सोर्स हु गेव हिम दैट फिगर, हाउ कम ही केम टू नो दैट 250 पीपल वर किल्ड, एंड दिस इज वेयर वी अक्यूज बीजेपी, वी अक्यूज आरएसएस फॉर पॉलिटिकलाइजिंग द actions of our army defense forces.
You have the BJP president announcing exactly how many people have died, and you have a cabinet member of the cabinet of the BJP saying that nobody has died, because the big government's intention was not to kill anybody, was only to send the message that they are capable. So they are talking in contradictory voices, and it is very clear that all they want to do is to politicize this issue.
Nearly a week after the Indian Air Force conducted the airstrikes on Jaish-e-Mohammed terror camps in Pakistan's Balakot, the nation is now witnessing a massive political war of words between the Congress and the BJP over the number of terrorists who were killed in that strike. While the Indian Air Force chief was very clear and said that the Indian Air Force was successful in targeting camps in Balakot and refused to give out any numbers, the BJP president, meanwhile, has come up with an estimate of 250. Let's take a look at this detailed report.
Air Force is not in a position to clarify that how many people were inside it. That we don't count human casualties. We count what targets have we hit or not hit.
The Indian Air Force pulled off a daring raid deep inside Pakistan when it bombed a terror camp of the Jaish-e-Mohammed, and its aircraft returned unscathed. But the government of India has tied itself in knots while projecting the airstrikes as big success. The very first day, sources in the government estimated the enemy casualty in the bomb attack at 300, a number that made headlines. Since then, many leaders have floated several numbers.
Modi ji oi ghotona howar por churute bhashon diyeche.
While Union Minister SS Ahluwalia claimed the aim was to send a message and not inflict large-scale destruction, his party chief stuck his neck out to give another estimate.
Narendra Modi sarkare barobar tirmana divse air strike kari 250 thi vadhar atankvadiyo ne shot.
The opposition, wary of being seen as questioning the armed forces, initially shied away from commenting on the airstrike success. The first salvo at the government was fired by Mamata Banerjee. Then the floodgates opened. The Congress has raised the stakes, with more coming forward to question the government.
Mr. Ahluwalia, who is in government, said that our intention was not to kill anybody, right? Now Amit Shah says 250 people have been killed. Now who should we believe? A minister of the government or Amit Shah, who is just a president of a party?
जिस तरह का प्रमाण अमेरिका की सरकार ने उसामा बिन लादेन के बारे में पूरे विश्व को दिया, उस तरह का प्रमाण हमको भी देना चाहिए।
तो सवाल बहुत
The gloves are off in this political face-off. Prime Minister Modi indicated as much at the India Today conclave, where he branded those raising questions as anti-national.
कुछ पार्टियां आतंक के खिलाफ हमारी लड़ाई पर संदेह कर रहे हैं। ये लोग मोदी विरोध करते करते देश विरोध पर उतर आए हैं।
Surgical strike after Uri attack was an election issue in Uttar Pradesh, which was swept by the BJP. Now the airstrike in Pakistan is set to be a talking point in the Lok Sabha general elections. The next few weeks will show who has upper hand in the political narrative over Balakot bombing. Bureau report, India Today.
Let me go straight across now to India Today's Moshmi for more details and updates. Moshmi, it is unfortunate how the airstrikes have become one big political spectacle, with the BJP and the Congress trading barbs at one another, especially at a time when the Indian Air Force chief himself has maintained and has clearly said how the Indian Air Force fighters had successfully bombed the targets in Balakot.
In fact, it was after his presser, his statement, that this also raked up a political storm, because even as he refused to divulge the casualty figures, you had figures being doled out by political leaders, and they were contradictory figures. This all started, if you remember, when the airstrikes happened. There were sources in the government that quoted a figure of 300, and now you have the BJP president who says that the number could be 250. So clearly, the Congress here not leaving an opportunity to hit back at the government for politicizing terror. And unfortunately, it is the election season. That's one reason why it has stirred the hornet's nest. If you see, even after the airstrikes happened and there was a call of solidarity from both sides, it is leaders of all political parties who have made public statements questioning the airstrikes, and that has given a lot of fodder to the international media and to the Pakistani media as well. But here, if you look at the government stand, it has changed, it has shifted, and the fact is that the government has not provided any evidence as far as the number of casualties
are concerned.
No official figure coming there, and that's one reason.
All right, Moshmi Singh there, thanks so much for joining us. Some breaking news coming in.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.